नमस्कार, राज्यसभा टीवी में आपके साथ मैं हूं अंकिता। और आइए आपको लिए चलते हैं इसरो की प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस में, जहां अंतरिक्ष विभाग में राज्य मंत्री जितेंद्र सिंह और इसरो प्रमुख के सीवन मीडिया को संबोधित कर रहे हैं।
आई थिंक दिस इज वन ऑफ द रेयर ओकेजंस वेयर वी आर होल्डिंग अ प्रेस ब्रीफिंग एक्सक्लूसिवली डिवोटेड टू द वर्क दैट इज बीइंग डन इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ स्पेस एंड द इसरो। And to an extent, this was a conscious decision because, incidentally and for reasons historic, the headquarters of the Department of Space happened to be in Bengaluru, and therefore sometimes the kind of information that is desired to be percolated here is missed out. I have to take pride in saying that we happen to be a part of Team ISRO at a time when in the field of space technology, India has emerged as a frontline nation. And you would realize the incredible, miraculous part of it if you can visualize that we started off much later compared to some of the other nations, like, for example, the USA or the erstwhile Soviet Union. And when they started off their space journey, our relationship with space was merely that of poetry, Chanda Mama Dur Ke. And sometimes I tend to believe what people would have thought of Sarabhai and his colleagues when they ruled out this ambitious program. People must have made fun of them. But today, as was mentioned by the chairman yesterday in his press briefing in Bengaluru, we are on the verge of sending Chandrayaan-2. But what I wish to add is, and I said that in lighter way in the other day, US was the first country in the world to have landed a man on the surface of moon, called Neil Armstrong, who made that famous observation that one step for man, a giant step for mankind. He had a walk around, but he missed seeing what Chandrayaan went and saw, the presence of water on the surface of moon. So it was much later. The American was the first to land up a man way back in 1969. So that is the kind of expertise over the years, the credit for which goes to the hard work and committed dedication in the scientific fraternity in the Department of Space. Having said that, two quick points which would possibly be of news interest. Chandrayaan has been already spoken about yesterday. I don't wish to repeat. If you desire so, we can do that, or the chairman can read out. On the eve of the 75th independence anniversary of India in 2022, ISRO has resolved to send its first human mission into the space. It could be even before 2022, or close to that. That's our ambitious preparation going on. There might be some confusion in saying that there was a human being called Rakesh Sharma who had gone into the space, but the mission was not Indian. So a purely make in India mission from nut bolt to the launching prepared at ISRO and carrying a crew of 2 to 3 persons. The selection process undertaken by a team of scientists headed by the chairman is already going on. An exclusive special cell has been created called the Gaganyaan National Advisory Council to monitor the planning, the preparation of this mission, which of course, as you would have realized, would be called Gaganyaan. The finalization of the 2 to 3 persons or the astronauts, or the crew who would be going for the mission would happen within next 6 months. And then, of course, the training period extends from 1.5 to 2 years, depending upon a number of factors, which also include the individual biological and adaptation factors. The cost for that mission as approved by the Union Cabinet shortly before the Code of Conduct was announced, is rupees 10,000 crore. And this is going to be a major breakthrough, as has been in the case of Chandrayaan and also the Mars mission. The pictures obtained from these two missions are now being procured even by some of the premier space centers in the world, including NASA. And the second part, I think, which would of course be a reiteration, but I, without sounding modest, can take due credit that in the last 5 years, I think another breakaway has been that we have succeeded in carrying space technology to every Indian household. And why I use this expression is that it was under the leadership of Prime Minister Narendra Modi that we embarked on an exercise to work out the applications of space technology in every other sphere, particularly in the areas of infrastructure development, in the areas of security concerns. If you recall, about 3.5 years ago, there was a 2-day-long extensive brainstorming which was held in the Union Capital with the ministries and officers of different departments on the one hand and the space scientists on the other hand to work out how well the space technology could step in. In the Modi government, a number of new initiatives, like for example the geotagging of Manrega, the soil testing, the surveys being conducted for the construction of roads and buildings are being extensively used through space applications. Of course, disaster management we were already doing. We have further improvised on that, and today we are even providing assistance to the other nations in disaster situations. Unmanned railway crossings, which has been taken up in the last 1.5 years with the use of space technology. On the one hand, all these applications have helped us in saving time. They have proved cost effective and in certain cases also avoided the possibilities of pilferage happening. In the Northeast, which also I happen to be responsible for, we are now also applying space technology for the procurement of utilization certificates of various projects happening, whether it's a road or the building projects. It will be real-time, foolproof, cost-effective, and nobody can take a picture of one bridge and fudge it as another bridge. In the area of security, particularly to check the infiltrations across the border, we had all the provisions earlier. We had scannings, we had fencing, we had thermal detection. Added to that now, as a part of my constituency, incidentally, also happens to be including the international border, we now have computerized monitoring through the satellite images. You can actually see the person on the other side of water. And the houses, you can peep and you can zoom in if you find something suspicious happening or a suspicious movement happening. And immediately, the programming is such that an alarm sets in and the security forces get alerted. So that is, I think, one huge achievement in the last 4 to 5 years, which we intend to carry forward, because as we move on and on, we'll learn more and more about the various applications which can be put into use to bring about ease of living and ease of business. No, if you want to trap me that way, I refuse to do so, for the simple reason there have been applications earlier also. As I said, space technology started in early 60s when we were still reciting poetry. But if you see the latest gadgets that have been put across, and I would rather, because that's a treat to watch, which happened through the Home Ministry. This is the first of its kind. The latest applications which are being used, and I believe they were emulated from the Israeli experience also. So it's relatively, the space technology was already there, satellite imaging provisions were already there, but how to apply them and to apply them extensively has happened in the last 2 to 3 years. And certainly, this is one of the latest improvisations. It keeps improving every day. In fact, in the countries abroad, now they have even private applications. They are private detectives using space technology to check movements. I can hire a detective if I want to check the movement of a person I wish to do so. So this is a continuous process. But certainly, the extensive use of applications in infrastructural development has happened in the last 3 to 4 years. Earlier on, you would recall, there would be a news sometime when a rocket was launched in Sriharikota. And India's space technology received a big hype, universally worldwide, through Mars mission, through Chandrayaan. Only, I think the other day, there was a write-up about NASA appreciating the discovery of water through Chandrayaan, because that is an indicator of the possibility of Indian or a possibility of a human habitat happening there. About Chandrayaan 2, I think the chairman has already given an elaborate description. If you want to him to repeat some of those, because this has been widely covered, I think, in most of the print media and electronic media. Chandrayaan 2, as he's already mentioned, is going to be launched on the 15th of July, tentatively. It will land in September. It will carry a rover. It will be an extension of Chandrayaan 1. And the entire world is very keenly looking forward to its to the kind of information and inputs which it procures. You wish to add, Dr. Sivan, something about it? We have a presentation also. Yes. Okay, before the presentation, yes.
ये सारी ट्रेनिंग उनकी इंडिया में होगी या अब्रॉड?
इंडिया में ट्रेन करने वाले भी हिंदुस्तानी, ट्रेनिंग प्राप्त करने वाले भी हिंदुस्तानी, धरती भी हिंदुस्तानी, सिर्फ आसमान दुनिया का. If you want precise names of the members, is it be okay
broadly,
to
who are
disclose
these,
that?
Who are all the stakeholders?
He is going to give a presentation.
I'll tell that.
Right. Shall we request the chairman to go ahead with the presentation? Yeah, because if there's anything else, then from the presentation, we'll get more inquisitive, no? Thank you for your patient hearing, because space is a subject which usually does not attract that kind of attention sometimes. But the kind of achievement, I think again the credit goes to Team ISRO headed by Dr. Sivan, that space is now attracting more and more of space in the print. Presentation. It's an extension, broadly speaking, it's an extension of the earlier lunar mission, but in the presentation it will come.
So, good afternoon to all of you. Most respected Honorable Minister of State, Jitendra Singh Ji, and all my friends from media. Just I wanted to tell that what I wanted to talk already that our Honorable Minister has spoken. The vision of Indian space program is mainly to make use of the space technology for unserved and underserved the people. That is, Definitely, the people from the cosmetic area, they will get all the benefits of latest technology. How to bring the latest technology to the remote places and the people under trouble, that's what the purpose of the space technology's vision, mainly to serve the people in the areas of safety, security, and quality of life. And whenever we have the cyclone, the satellite pictures are really predicting the cyclone path so that the people can be evacuated and they can avoid the huge catastrophe. And when you are launching the satellite, the satellite is providing the broadband connectivity for the unconnected areas of the country. Like that, I can go on add. At present, the Vikas Sarabhai's vision of space technology, space system, is to meet the requirements of the people, to meet the safety, security, and quality of the every citizen of India. That's what very beautifully narrated by our Honorable Minister. Now, having done these requirements, having met the requirement, now ISRO is marching towards the second vision. What should be the second vision? Definitely, we are meeting all the requirements of the human being. The second mission should be exploring the secrets of inner solar system and human space flight is the aspiration of not only Indian scientific community, but the global scientific community as well. And India, as a space-faring nation, should play a significant role in this endeavor. Well, navigation, communication, Earth observation is the sensing missions are going to be bread and butter for us. If the missions like Chandrayaan, Mangalyaan, Gaganyaan, which excites the youth and unites the nation, as well as provide the technological seeds for the future. The 50 years back, whatever the technological seed sown by the Vikas Sarabhai, the benefit we are enjoying now. So for the 50 years later, for the future generation, what is the type of technology we should provide? That is our necessity. That is the second vision. That is nothing but the missions to interplanetary missions, also human space mission into the orbit mission. These are the visions what we have. As a first, we had already Chandrayaan-1 and MoS missions in this the area. And now we are getting ready for a next major mission from India, that is Chandrayaan-2. Chandrayaan-2 mission is planned to have the launch by July 15th, early morning, 2:51. That was a launch time, what we are planning. And the Chandrayaan-2 mission contains three components. That is the rover, which is having 27 kg, and we have next one is a lander that's having about 1.4 ton. This rover is kept inside the lander. This lander is kept on an orbiter. The orbiter is the 2.4 ton. The total composite module is mass about 3.8 ton. And this composite body is kept on the heat shield of the GSLV Mark III vehicle. And then we will be launching that one. This launch only I am telling on 15th July, 2:51 early morning. And once it is launched, in the high eccentric orbit with a 38,000 kilometer orbit size. But we know that Moon is 384,000 kilometer away from Earth. So from the launch vehicle orbit, using orbital propulsion, we are rising for 16 days, five times the orbit of the composite body. And the 16th day, we are having one very good maneuver called translunar injection, which takes the composite body to Moon. And that is 384,000 kilometers away from Earth. It will take 5 days to travel to Moon area. At the Moon, again, the lunar orbital insertion maneuver will happen, which will put the composite body around Moon, by 150 by 18,000 kilometer orbit. Subsequently, next 27 days, the orbiter of the propulsion system of the orbiter continuously burned to reduce the orbit of the composite body to 100 by 100 kilometer. At the appropriate time, the orbiter will be separating from the lander, and the lander will burn to make the orbit still lower to 30 kilometer. At a suitable day, at 30 kilometer onwards, the real breaking of the velocity of the lander happens. It takes the 15 minutes from the starting of the breaking of the velocity to landing. This 15 minutes is going to be the most terrifying moment for all the people who belong to ISRO, probably for the scientists and people of India also. Yeah, this 15 minutes is going to be the most difficult task that ever ISRO has undertaken a mission to land it on that. After landing, after everything is all right, the door will open and the rover will come out. And it will take about 4 hours for rover to come out. And then it will move around the lunar surface. A maximum it can go up to 500 meters. And after this one, this orbiter, as well as lunar and rover, will do experiments and to create science. That information, as a image, it will be coming to the Earth for analyzing and the carrying out the job. And what are the type of science we are expecting this mission is mainly finding out the mapping of the rock-forming elements like magnesium, iron, calcium, so on, that one. The identification of minerals, identification of helium, water, then identification of the exosphere of the moon. Then that we have that is the three orbital elements, the payload elements in the lander. That really will give the moon quake as well as that plasma of the surface. Then it will measure the thermal conductivity, the temperature profile of the subsurface. The rover will do the experiment on the chemical composition and the minerals of the lunar surface. Now, what the specialty of this particular mission is, we are landing at a place where nobody else have gone. Honorable Minister told, Chandrayaan-1 only found that water, not the other the missions. Similarly, this mission, we are going to go to a place where nobody has gone. And this place is in more shadow region of the moon. So we are expecting that a lot of new science is expected to come from this particular thing. And this mission is a national endeavor, not only by ISRO alone. More than 500 industries across the country is contributing the launch vehicle of this mission. And around 120 industries are participating in this endeavor. Also, that nearly 80% of the cost of the launch vehicle is lying in industry, and 60% of the cost of the Chandrayaan-2, it is going to be in the industry. So this mission is not only that ISRO's mission, it is the mission of the entire country. That way I would say. And in this mission, we are going to achieve a new history in the not only in India, but amongst the entire global community by going to a place where nobody else has gone. Now, having achieved this particular mission of Chandrayaan-2, what next? We are going to have the Aditya alone mission. Yes, this mission, we have not talked to anybody else. First time it is coming to media, Aditya alone mission. It is going to have a mission to Sun, to study the corona of Sun. This mission will be going to one point called L1, that is Liberation Point 1, and the Earth-Moon system, Earth-Sun system.
So please repeat, what is the
L4? Liberation Point 1. That is, there are the five liberation points for the Earth-Sun system. This is the one of the points it will going. That is 1.5 million kilometers away from Earth. And by keeping a satellite at that place, that satellite will be moving along with the Earth-Sun way. The way Earth is moving around the Sun, the same way this point also will move. That way the satellite we are placing that one is always look at the Sun without any break. That will give an analysis or science of the Sun's corona. Why we have to study the Sun's corona is, all of you are aware, Sun's corona is having a major impact on the climate changes. How the climate changes, it depends on how that the corona is changing. That we have already studied that. It is a very, very important mission. This is going to have mission by next year, middle. But first half, we are going to have this mission, Aditya L1 mission. And the next mission, what we are going to have is the mission to Venus. Not only Mars, not only Moon. We want to go to another planet, that is Venus. This particular mission, it is going to have a very, very important mission because Venus is a burning body. It's a very heat, high temperature body. And most of the missions have failed. We wanted to succeed. It is mainly to understand the study of the atmospheric property of the Venus and the composition of that atmosphere. It is going to give that. It is that throughout the world, it's a very big need. And we have announced the opportunity for international and as well as Indian scientists. We got a lot of payloads. Finally, we screened out the 23 payloads. This also going to happen maybe another 2-3 years from now, this mission. And next mission, what we are talking is that our government's the flagship program, Honorable Minister said, Our Honorable Prime Minister announced the last Independence Day, before the 75th anniversary of the independence, we need to put a human in Indian to space by our own rocket. This is the target our Honorable Prime Minister has made. And based on the requirements or demand by the Prime Minister, we worked out a configuration, that Gaganyaan configuration. This have one crew module called the one in the picture. You can see that the orbital module, the top portion, the brown portion is called crew module. The human are going to stay there only. The bottom portion is a service module that really giving the service for the crew people sitting in the brown portion. That is crew module. The entire combination is called orbital module. This orbital module is kept on the GSLV Mark III, and we are going to have a launch. And before really doing the human mission, before the December 2021, we need to have two trials without human, that is unmanned mission, the same configuration, so that we have a very good clarity, then we will fly. And this is a very, very tight schedule. And for making this mission possible, not only ISRO is required, and we need to bring the national, all the lab institutions, facilities we have to bring in the loop. IAF, IAM, DRDO labs, and academic institutions, industry, everybody has to be there. And to ensure that this project to happen nicely without any problem, that's what Honorable Prime Minister said, that the Gaganyaan Advisory, National Advisory Council formed. This has the members from different industry, different institutions. Members like our Dr. Kasturirangan is a member, and the Principal Scientific Advisor to Prime Minister is a member. And the Sajid Reddy, the DRDO chairman, is a member. And the secretary, the Science and Technology Department, is a member. And members from that industries, L&T, Godrej, like that, from big industry, the bosses are members. So that it is having the wider cross-section of the entire the national level leaders, so that they will be advising this Gaganyaan program at the right time to have the, at the right decision. That is the thing. Now, it is, we have already that they have a MOU with the Indian Air Force to select the crew and to train the crew in India. The crew will be first trained in India, initial training. And the subsequently, the advanced training, right now we don't have the facilities in India. And for that, we may have to go abroad for advanced training purpose. And for the first mission, because the target set is so short that we, the time is not sufficient to establish the facility. We'll be making use of the abroad facilities first for that training. But the basic training will be done here. Also, the module-specific training will be done here. Now, having achieved this Gaganyaan program by December 2021, is it the human space program going to be stopped? No. We have to continue, we have to sustain the program for the remaining part of the period also. So subsequently, as a long-term plan, we are planning to have the space station by India, our own space station. Then subsequently, not only the space station we are going to stop it, we are going to join the international community for going to moon, manned mission to moon, then the asteroid, and we want to create the colonies in the moon. So like we have a very, very clear plan how to go to the airport space, human the space program. That's what Honorable Minister said. Now, we are seeing that this mission, how the Gaganyaan mission is going to be there. It will take about 16 minutes from to launch the persons from the Earth to move the orbit. And another 36 minutes it will take the people from the orbit to Earth. Already the selection process for that thing is going on. And not only selection process, but after the astronauts are landed on either on the surface or at the ocean, we need a recovery crew. So we need support from Navy, Coast Guard. That also that already that the discussions are on. So that way we are going to have a very, very the great mission. And the first unmanned mission is going to be there in the coming the next year, December, very soon. And then followed by the second unmanned mission be another 6 months. Then we will have the real human the space flight by 2021 December. So we are working on that. So what I want to impress upon all the media people is ISRO, well, the vision one, the purpose is to meet the requirements of the people in the areas of safety, security, and quality of life. That's the vision one. That we have already 49 satellites are doing the job, and we are going to continue the job by launching more and more advanced satellites. At the same time, we want to have a vision two. It is for seeding the scientific and technological the developments for the future generation. The second vision is includes the missions to that the other bodies, that is astronomical bodies, like other planetary bodies. That's a mission. That's the one. Another area is the human in space mission, and in all the areas, ISRO is working, and we'll be ensuring that we'll be succeeding. All this is with the help of the Indian people. Thank you very much for the patient here.
Thank you.